agricultural locational theory. When we discuss about the crops, which crop should be grown and where a particular crop is grown, it's all based on several parameters. When a farmer raises a crop, a particular crop in a particular field, farmer decide, consider so many factors. Which high yield variety seeds should be used, whether the indigenous seeds should be used, what the selection of the crop, which crop should be cultivated in a particular field, all these desires, they are decided by considering series of parameters. किसान किसी खेत में ऐसे ही कोई फसल नहीं उगा लेता है. He considers so many factors. I simply wanted to give you a list. Farmer consider the nature of the soil. Farmer consider the climatic conditions, soil moisture, availability of water, demand of the market, availability of the finance, the price of the cost of their product. आज किसका रेट ज़्यादा चल रहा है, मार्केट में डिमांड किसकी ज़्यादा है, मुझे इसमें इन्वेस्टमेंट के लिए पैसा मिलेगा या नहीं मिलेगा. सो देयर आर यू कैन से वेरी इंट्रिकेट प्लेथोरा ऑफ एस्पेक्ट्स व्हेन फार्मर डिसाइड व्हिच क्रॉप शुड बी कल्टीवेटेड एंड वेयर. नियर द सिटी यू नो मोस्ट ऑफ द डेयरी फार्मिंग इज वेरी जनरली फाउंड इन द आउटर मार्जिन ऑफ द सिटी. व्हाई? बिकॉज मिल्क इज ए perishable product. It should be reached to the end consumer at the earliest possible. Farmer is producing little amount of milk. He cannot construct or develop a pasteurization unit of his own. तो छोटा छोटा 2 किलो 5 किलो 10 किलो दूध अगर कोई किसान बेचता है तो उसका दूध the milk should reach to the end consumer at the earliest possible. So in such condition this farming dairy rearing cannot be performed away from the city. It should be near the market, near the city. So the localization of what type of crops, sometimes intensity of crops, in some of the areas agriculture is very intensive, some of the areas agriculture is quite extensive, farmers are not using the land very intensively. It is all determined by the several geographical parameters. So in order to that, one German geographer also gave one localization theory where what crop should be grown. But in before this, I want to give you a list. To grow a particular crop in a particular field, ek hi gaon mein ek kisan ke 4 alag alag plot hai at 4 different places. If this is one of the villages, in this village there are the farmlands. All these farmlands are divided into the acres. If this is the settlement of the village in the central place, yahan settlement hai. If a farmer is having one plot is here, one plot is here, one plot is here, and one plot is here. In 4 different plots, he will decide which crop should be because this is the farthest. This is here, he may be having 4 plots here together. Yahan 4 hai. He is having one. It is very close to the village. So the nature of the crop would be different here. If he is rearing the livestock, so he will raise the green fodder for the cattle. Roz lana padta hai na chara pashuon ke liye. To gaon ke nazdeek wale khet mein wo chara fodder grow karega. Since he is having 4 plots together, so he must be having some source of his own irrigation. So he will decide the crops, water intensive crops, and this is quite far off, maybe some grains, coarse grains. If water is not available, this is the farthest possible, he cannot take care of the land. So he may raise some cereals which require lesser attention, lesser irrigation or lesser investment because this is the farthest place. So near the village, intensity of farming is different. Away from the village, intensity. The choice of the cropping system is different at different places. So in this, in continuity of this, I want to just give you a factors which decide, factors to determine the crops. Localization of crops. किसी क्रॉप के ग्रो करने के लिए व्हाट आर द फैक्टर्स रेस्पॉन्सिबल. सम फैक्टर्स आर द ज्योग्राफिकल फैक्टर्स, यू कैन से नेचुरल फैक्टर्स, लाइक सम नेचुरल फैक्टर्स. क्लाइमेट इज वन ऑफ द फैक्टर. क्लाइमेट हैव द रेनफॉल, अमाउंट ऑफ रेनफॉल. द टेम्परेचर इज द पैरामीटर. नेचर ऑफ द सोयल, सोयल में भी दे आर द डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ सोयल. एसिडिक सोयल, एल्केलाइन सोयल, कोर्सर सोयल, porous soil, impervious soil, plain, and other, apart from that, relief. Relief is there, whether the plots are plain or the slope or the undulated topography is there. They are the relief plus shape of the plot, shape plus size of the plot. They all are decided by the farmers before taking into the consideration that which crop should be cultivated in a particular field. किसी खेत में कोई फसल उगाते हैं तो उससे पहले वो इन aspects को, apart from that, farmer also take consideration of market price. Market price, farmer also take the consideration of the demand of the market, market demand. किस चीज की डिमांड है. समटाइम्स यू नो इन इंडिया द बिगेस्ट प्रॉब्लम ऑफ द फार्मर इज देयर फ्लक्चुएटिंग प्राइस. समटाइम्स द ऑनियन प्राइसेस आर एज हाई एज 100 रुपीज पर केजी. समटाइम्स ऑनियंस एंड द पोटैटो, यू नो दिस ईयर लखनऊ में क्या हुआ, किसानों ने लखनऊ में सड़कों पे पोटैटो डाल दिए. दे हैव सरप्लस पोटैटो प्रोडक्शन, मार्केट प्राइस इज लेसर देन देयर प्रोडक्शन कॉस्ट. पैदा करने में आलू को पैदा करने में कम से कम 15 से 20 रुपए किलो का खर्चा लगता है. अगर उसको 5 रुपए किलो मिलेगा तो क्या करेगा वो, ही विल थ्रो इट आउट, बट ही कैन नॉट सप्लाई टू द मार्केट. तो दैट्स, एंड समटाइम्स द प्राइस इज वेरी हाई. सो ऑलवेज प्राइसेस आर फ्लक्चुएटिंग बिकॉज एग्रीकल्चर इज इन इंडिया इज इन अनऑर्गेनाइज सेक्टर. हमारी एक्सपोर्ट इम्पोर्ट पॉलिसी इज ऑल्सो वेरिंग. Sometimes, you know, last week professor, which professor? Qureshi. Professor M.H. Qureshi, who was delivering the lecture, that our, he said that our India is a country of dal roti. North India mein kisi se baat karenge dal roti. Dal, pulse is the most important food ingredient. And our demand, national demand of the pulse in the country is 23 million ton. Our production is only 19 million ton. We are dependent on the imported pulse. हम बाहर से आयात करते हैं. We are importing from the small countries like Mozambique, like Tanzania and the other Southeast Asian countries, Malaysia. यहाँ से हम import करते हैं. So sometimes our like onion. Onion, when we started onion from the Afghanistan, the size of onion of Afghanistan is like this. 1 kilo ka 750 gram ka ek onion hota hai. In a general Indian society, we need small onion. Ek kaata usko kha liya. 1 kilo ke mein to kaatenge to uska 100 gram 200 gram kaat ke usko khali nahi chhodte hain. So the price is cheaper but demand is not there. Sometimes it is also the factor. 1 kilo ke onion ko hum nahi kharidte Afghanistan wale ko, kyunki usko ek piece kaat ke usko rakhna padta hai. Onion is a kind of product, it should be consumed completely, nahi to pure ghar mein smell phail jati hai. So it cannot be stored, it's a perishable product. Ek bar kaata to kharab ho jata hai. So isliye sometimes several parameters, apart from that, availability of fund availability with the farmers, fund availability with the farmers, it is determined by the, you know, banks, bank facility, I mean loan facility. lawn facility is one of the important. So these are some of the factors which determine that before locating the crop, in which field, which crop should be cultivated. Near the city, near the market, we have the different type of crops. Away from the market, we have different type of crop. Even at micro level, at village level, we select the crops according to the geographic combination of geographical and human conditions. So these are some of the factors which determine the localization. And in continuation of the agricultural localization theory, we have in 1826, you mean 19th century, early 19th century, one small farmer of 20 years old is a farmer at Tolo's farm, land in Germany. John Henrik von Thunen, हम उनको von Thunen ही बोलते हैं. John Henrik X von Thunen. He was a farmer in Germany near Berlin. He had his own farmland. He was doing the agriculture on a very scientific basis. He was carrying the record of the data, investment and output, and simultaneously he developed a model, and later he converted the model into theory. और उस theory को हम सब पढ़ते हैं. But this theory, he gave the concentric zone model of agricultural location. Concentric zonation model. Zonation theory. This is agricultural concentric zonation theory, and in this model, von Thunen, he published this model in 1826, but it was popularized in 1960s, 1956, when it was translated into English after 75 years. When it was translated into English by the American and English geographers, agricultural geographers, and this model was popularized accordingly. So in Peter Hall, actually in 1956, one Peter Hall was one agricultural geographer of England. He published this material, translated from German to English, then it was the popularized, and it became a very important source of learning for the geographers to understand the localization model. What was the objective? So objective of this agricultural zones, this theory was, if you just say objective. Objective was, just quickly you write the objective, how the distance from market changes the cropping pattern and land use pattern. Cropping pattern and land use pattern. Objective was how the distance from market changes the intensity and land use pattern. How it has changed the intensity and the cropping pattern and land use pattern. So for this he used two models. Not cropping intensity, cropping pattern hona chahiye. I should write here cropping pattern. Cropping pattern. And he used two models to explain it. जब market से जब दूर जाते हैं तो किसान खेती करने का तरीका बदल देता है, pattern बदल देता है, crops बदल देता है, crop की crop input बदल देता है. Near the city, farmers are more innovative. They are using the land very intensively. They have the availability of the finance. But when they go away from the market, the nature of farming becomes extensive. And how it develops. So he said there are the two models. One is the production crop intensity decreases. He said in these two models, first model he said cropping intensity decreases when we go away from the market. Market से जब दूर जाते हैं तो agriculture की intensity घटने लगती है. Intensity means the labor input, the financial input, the input of the fertilizers, everything farmer everything keep decreases. Farmer remain no more scientific. Farmer started doing rudimentary farming. जैसे दिल्ली से 100 किलोमीटर दूर जाएंगे आपको कहीं कहीं बैल भी दिखाई दे जाएंगे, क्रॉपिंग डाइवर्सिटी भी दिखाई देगी. 100 किलोमीटर अवे 200 एनिमल्स लाइफ स्टॉक एनिमेट पावर यूज करते हुए मिलेंगे. एग्रीकल्चरल इंटेंसिटी डिक्रीजेस. दिस इज द वन व्हाट दिस वॉन्थुनन वांटेड टू से. सेकंड इज लैंड यूज पैटर्न. Further, one is intensity, second is land use pattern also changes. City से दूर जाते हैं तो land use का pattern बदलता जाता है. See the size of the plots may be different. City के नजदीक होंगे तो size of the plot may be lesser because उसमें intensive farming होती है. City से दूर जाएंगे तो size of the plot may be bigger. The selection of the crop in the near the city, selection of crop would be more intensive. और दूर जाएंगे तो so farmers may be more extensive kind of crops, coarse grains. Coarse grains are the grains which can be cultivated in adverse conditions, adverse climate, poor soil conditions, in the absence of water, dry land farming, जिनको ग्रो करने के लिए बहुत इन्वेस्टमेंट नहीं चाहिए. दे ग्रो इन नेचुरल कंडीशंस एंड कोर्स ग्रेन्स आर बेसिकली इंडिजेनस क्रॉप्स. हाइब्रिड वैरायटी सीड्स कैन नॉट बी कोर्स ग्रेन्स. सो कोर्स ग्रेन्स कल्टीवेशन सिटी से दूर जाते हैं तो हम कोर्स ग्रेन्स की लाइक बाजरा कैन बी रेज्ड इन एवरी कंट्री. रागी लाइक मड़ुआ लाइक ऑल दीज आर दी सम ऑफ द पल्सेस लाइक मोट यू नो बीकानेरी भुजिया. इसका जीआई टैग भी है. बीकानेरी भुजिया इज बेसिकली मेड अप ऑफ व्हाट विच आइटम किससे बनती है.
बेसन
किस चीज का बनता है.
चना.
हाँ नहीं यही मैं जानना चाहता था. वो मोट होती है और वो ड्राई कंडीशन में होती है और उसकी एडवांटेज ये है उसमें फर्टिलाइजर नहीं डाल सकते. जब सूखे में होगी तो फर्टिलाइजर दैट इज फ्री दैट इज ऑलमोस्ट ऑर्गेनिक क्रॉप. सो दैट्स व्हाई सिटी से दूर जाते हैं तो नेचर बदल जाती है क्रॉपिंग कोर्स ग्रेन्स की. सो टू गिव दिस मॉडल वॉन्थुनन मॉडल ऑफ कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड जोनेशन थ्योरी अबाउट द एग्रीकल्चरल लोकेशन. He said there are certain preconditions. Just quickly you write the 6 preconditions because let me read a few lines. One is farming activities are determined by many factors. Wonthunen uses the market as a factor. Market is one of the most important factor. And he used the market as to analyze the cropping intensity and land use change with increasing distance from the market. In two parameters के base पे उन्होंने कुछ preconditions बनाई हैं and उन preconditions के base पे Wonthunen basically developed some preconditions. क्या precondition होनी चाहिए? Actually consider this is the model of 1826. 1826 we had no railway system spread over in the world, neither electricity. We were dependent on animate power. We had little hybrid variety seeds. Crop diversity भी नहीं थी. और ये this is the experiment of Germany. They don't have the much diversity of crops. Germany में तो एक या they have the temperate climate. They can take one crop in a year. Only in the spring season. They don't have summer season. They have the spring season. तो साल में एक ही फसल ले सकते हैं और उस फसल में कुछ गिनी चुनी तीन चार फसलें बो सकते हैं. हमारे यहाँ तो साल में तीन फसलें लेते हैं और हर फसल में 10 फसलें इकट्ठी उगा सकते हैं. इफ रबी में वी हैव 10 टाइप्स, वी आर इन द डिफरेंट क्लाइमेटिक कंडीशन, वी हैव मोर डाइवर्सिटी. दैट इज द कंट्री ऑफ कोलोनाइजेशन, टेम्परेट कंट्री एक तरह की. सो इट वॉज ईजी फॉर हिम टू डेवलप द प्री कंडीशन. हम यहाँ प्री कंडीशन लगाए तो लग ही नहीं सकती because we have more intricate conditions and more diversity. So some preconditions. मैं सिर्फ points लिखूंगा. First precondition is said there should be one isolated state. Isolated state means एक ऐसा area होना चाहिए. There should be some political area. This is isolated and it has no trade with, it is not dependent on the other region. So trade bhi nahi hoga. So it is self dependent region. Isolated hoga aur apne apni zarurate andar se hi puri karega. Aisa aaj ke zamane mein soch bhi nahi sakte, but this was the model. Second he said market in the center. Market is in the center of the isolated state. Center of isolated state. Market is in always there is in the center of the state. Third, he said, uniformly plain. This isolated plain is uniformly plain. Uniformly plain means they have the plain topography, uniform climate, uniform soil conditions, equitable supply of water, which is not possible. Which is not possible everywhere, but maybe where he was, he had his farmland. Von Thunen was performing this type of agriculture. Further, he gave the name that area is called isotropic plain. This word ko zara yaad rakhna, isotropic plain. Isotropic plain means any area with isotropic plain. And the third is farmers should be enterprising farmers means farmers should change their cropping pattern according to the demand of the city market. Farmers should raise the crop in accordance to the demand of the market. So they change the cropping pattern. अभी प्याज की जरूरत नहीं है, so they grow vegetables. अब vegetables की जरूरत नहीं है, they grow food grains. Whatever is required, they change their conditions. Then uniform, there should be a uniform mode of transport. Uniform mode of transport. Von Thunen के टाइम में ट्रांसपोर्ट का घोड़ा गाड़ी होती थी, बैलगाड़ी होती थी. एंड ही सेड ट्रांसपोर्ट कॉस्ट इंक्रीजेज इक्वली इन ऑल द डायरेक्शंस. किसी भी डायरेक्शन में डिस्टेंस के हिसाब से ट्रांसपोर्ट रेट बढ़ेगा इन टर्म्स ऑफ द वेट एंड द डिस्टेंस. सो ट्रांसपोर्ट कॉस्ट इज इक्वल, रेट्स आर इक्वल, ट्रांसपोर्ट रेट्स आर इक्वल. ट्रांसपोर्ट के रेट कहीं किसी भी डायरेक्शन में जाओ, कितना सामान लेके जाओ, सब रेट बराबर है, ऐसा हो ही नहीं सकता. देन फर्दर ही सेड फार्मर्स ग्रो, हियर आई सेड एंटरप्राइजिंग फार्मर्स, फार्मर्स ग्रो देयर क्रॉप्स, फार्मर्स फुलफिल द नीड ऑफ दिस सिटी, एंड इन लियू ऑफ दिस फार्मर्स ऑब्टेन देयर डोमेस्टिक requirement from the city, and the city fulfill the industrial product fulfill the demand of the farmers. City have different industrial products, utensils, clothing, medicines, all household items, those come through the industry. From the industry, after processing, farmers supply the agricultural product and purchase the industrial product. So city is a self-sufficient city. So he developed this precondition, and in this precondition he used the word one economic rent, and this economic rent farmers von Thunen used the word economic rent. Economic rent, ये वाला rent नहीं है, किराए वाला rent नहीं है. Economic rent means input plus transport cost. जो cost है उसमें से we minus it. Cost of the agricultural product, कितने का सामान बिका, उसमें से खर्चा कितना हुआ, उसमें ट्रांसपोर्ट कॉस्ट कितना बचा, और लास्ट में जो प्रॉफिट मिला, प्रॉफिट मींस इट इज द इकोनॉमिक रेंट. सो आउट ऑफ द टोटल इन्वेस्टमेंट कॉस्ट, सॉरी इन्वेस्टमेंट कॉस्ट, प्रोडक्ट कॉस्ट, दिस इज द प्रोडक्ट कॉस्ट, प्रोडक्ट कॉस्ट माइनस इनपुट एंड माइनस, इसमें माइनस करेंगे इनपुट में से फर्दर, सॉरी इनपुट और इसको ऐड कर सकते हैं, मतलब कि इसको एक इकट्ठा कर सकते हैं. इस सेट जितना खर्चा आया उसको निकालेंगे. दिस इज द ट्रांस इकोनॉमिक रेंट, एंड फॉर इकोनॉमिक रेंट दिस ही गेव एन एग्जांपल, रादर ही गेव ए फॉर्मूला टू डिटरमाइन द इकोनॉमिक रेंट. इकोनॉमिक रेंट में उसने कहा प्रोडक्शन कॉस्ट इज इक्वल एवरीवेयर. अगर किसी आइसोलेटेड स्टेट में गेहूं यहां पैदा करते हैं या गेहूं यहां पैदा करते हैं तो प्रोडक्शन कॉस्ट विल रिमेन सेम, एंड द प्राइस ऑफ द